Hello children, hope you are all safe at home, right? Yeah. In the present situation, we are facing so many problems like coronavirus, isn't it? Present situation problem is coronavirus, right? Yeah. We are hearing in the news channels, everywhere, outside about this coronavirus, right? So, I would like to give some information about virus. Coronavirus is a one kind of virus. What it is? It is a kind of virus. What is virus then? It's nothing but a microbe. So today I would like to give a small information about microbes. My topic is microbes. So microbes also called microorganisms. What we call? Microorganisms. See here in the word only telling. Micro means small. Do you know the meaning of micro? Micro means small. Small or tiny. Understood? Small or tiny. Organism means you are already learned in previous classes, isn't it? What you learn? Organism is made up of cell, right? What is cell then? Cell is nothing but the basic unit of life, isn't it? What is cell? It is the basic unit of life. See here, cell. Tell me children, group of cells make a tissue. Group of tissues make an organ, right? Group of organs make an organism, isn't it? Right? So, organism is nothing but group of cells, right? So, microorganism, here in the word saying that microorganism means small living organisms. Have you understood now? Now, here, children, I am keeping a dot here. Can you able to see this? Yes. This dot you can able to see. It is also small, right? Small. But we can see. Microbes are very small living organisms. We can't see with our eyes. We cannot see with our eyes. Those are very extremely minute size. Because of their very extremely, means very very small in size. That's why those are unable to visible. Understood? Those are invisible to our naked eye. So, that can be seen with a specific instrument. We can see those microbes with the help of a specific instrument. That instrument name is microscope. What is that? Instrument, microscope. Understood? With the help of microscope, we can see very minute things. What is this microscope? It analyzes means it shows that small microbe into a big one, so that we can able to see that microbes in the with the help of microscope. I'll show a picture for you, that microscope. See children, this is the microscope picture. This is the shape of the microscope. Understood? So, with this help of microscope, we are placing the sample. Sample means any drop, water drop. Understood? So, if you place here in the water drop, how many microbes means microbes are there? You can able to see that. Understood? With the help of this microscope. Right? Next, coming to where we find these microbes. We find these microbes everywhere. Everywhere means all places. Means in the air, in the water, on the land, even on the plants, animals, and even human beings. Like us. Means everywhere. See, we can't say that this microbe is not at all present in this place. We can't say. Why? Because those are widely spread living organisms everywhere. Okay. Which organism is widely spread on this earth? It means only microbes. Got it, children? Tell me now, which organism widely spreads on this earth? Which organism? Living organism, that is microbe. Microbe is a living organism. It spreads widely on this earth. Understood? Not plants and animals, right? Microbes are widely spread because those are very minute insects. Got it? Now, coming to where they grow. They grow, see, I said they found, where they found? They found in air, water, okay, land, on the plants, land has plants and animals, right? And even human, on the human beings or inside the human beings, we can find these microbes. That means everywhere. What is the place? Everywhere. Everywhere we find these microbes. Understood? Everywhere. So there is no particular place for this microbe. This is not present in this place. Everywhere it is present. Now coming to where they grow. They grow in a particular place because nothing but if they find a proper food, they find proper food or moisture. Moisture means wet, wet place. Understood? Or a particular temperature. Having a particular temperature. Understood? And also in the presence of oxygen. Some can live without oxygen also. Some microbes can live without oxygen also. Understood? Proper means suitable condition. For them, if they find suitable condition, understood, then they can able to grow. Got it? Have you understood, children? Now, so they grow very fastly when they find a suitable condition. Can I give one example for you where they grow very fastly? Where they grow means in our mouth. Understood? What is the place they can grow very fastly? One of the example is our mouth only. In our mouth, it is a very suitable condition for the microbe to grow very well. Grows very rapidly. That's why if you are not brushing teeth properly, then what happens, shall we? You'll get teeth decay, right? Decay means it's not good, right? It's spoiled, right? Teeth going to spoil if you are not brushing properly. Why? Because of microbes. Understood, children? So these microbes grow very well in our mouth. So you just brush your teeth regularly, twice a day, understood, and avoid from the tooth decay. Got it? Now, so where we find where they grow, I said. Now coming to types of microbes. Types. There are mainly four types of microbes. How many types? Four types. First one is bacteria. First type is bacteria. Second one is protozoa. What is the type of microbe? This is one kind of microbe. Understood? It is a protozoa. Next one is fungi. And last one is virus. Understood? Now our coronavirus comes under this category. Virus. Got it? Now coming to first one, bacteria. This bacteria is everywhere. Means abundant, more in number. Out of all these microbes, which one is more abundant means? More in number means bacteria. Understood? Which one is more? Bacteria. Among all these, which one is the smallest one? Virus. Virus is the smallest one. Understood? Bacteria is the abundant one. Means abundant. Abundant means more. Understood? More. Next, coming to protozoa. Protozoa is also big in size but smaller than bacteria. When compared to bacteria, it is somewhat big in size. Have you understood, children? So protozoa is somewhat big in size than bacteria. Now coming to fungi. Fungi looks like plants. Those are looking like plants, children. So where we find this one means generally mushrooms. Are you eating mushrooms? And bread. When you are eating bread, if you are not eating bread and keep the bread like that for some days, have you seen small dots on it? that is nothing but molds, one kind of fungi. Understood? So protozoa is bigger than bacteria. Where we find this protozoa? In the water bodies. Where we find? In the water bodies like ponds, lakes, ditches, moist places. All moist places you find this protozoa. Have you understood, children? Now coming to fungi, I said these are looking like plants, but those are not plants. Plants are having chlorophyll, right? They are green in color, but fungi is not at all having chlorophyll. Understood? But they depend on other for food and they grow very well. These microbes depend on other for their food and grow very well, very rapidly. Mushrooms, have you seen mushrooms grown on a specific log of a tree, right? Next, coming to virus, our specific one is coronavirus, I said, no? So I'll tell you about that a little bit, and I'll show you the pics of those microbes also one by one. This bacteria, children, this bacteria is in different shapes: circular shape, cylindrical shape, rod shape. Understood? In different shapes, not in a particular shape, but all these are, even protozoa, all these are single cell microbes, single cell microorganisms, all these are. Understood? And this one is in different shapes, and some is not having a particular shape. See, I'm giving examples. These are in various shapes, and here some examples are there for protozoa. Examples are like amoeba, paramecium is in slipper shape. Do you know the slipper? We are wearing slipper, right? Like this is shape. Understood? So paramecium, amoeba is shapeless. It's in different shape. Understood? Next one is euglena. These are all examples for protozoa. Now coming to fungi. Fungi examples, I said no, mushrooms. Mushroom is one kind of fungi, and also molds are found on the spoiled bread. Understood? Whenever it's spoiled, then we can find molds on it. Got it, children? Now coming to virus. Virus is the smallest one, I said. Among all these microbes, virus is the smallest one, and also it not at all comes under, remember, it is not at all comes under living organism. It is not at all living thing. I am saying these are all microbes. Microbes are small, tiny living organisms, I am saying, no? But virus is not at all living thing. Then what it is? See here. All of you look at here. Virus. Virus is not a living thing. Then it is in between the borderline of living and non-living. Suppose think it is a living. What it is? This is living thing and this one is non-living. Understood? It is in between the borderline, means it is not a living, it is not a non-living. Then what? See, this is a very minute, okay, creature. It floats in the air. It moves in the air. Okay. It moves in the, floats in the air. And it is harmless. Won't cause anything. But whenever it come in contact with a living thing, then it start becoming alive. Alive means it is also becoming, it multiplies and divides inside that living thing and start causes diseases. Even see, living things like plants, animals and humans, all these are living things, we said, no? This virus is generally harmful when it is in air. Okay, when it is in the air, it is harmless. But whenever it come in contact with a living thing, like a plant cell, animal cell or a human cell, okay, plant cell, animal cell, human cell, and even bacterial cell. I said bacteria is a abundant microbe, no? Even in this also whenever it come in contact with that, contact means attach, whenever it come in contact with the bacterial cell, it become alive, then it start multiplying and spreading and causes diseases in all these living things. Have you understood, children? That's why our coronavirus nowadays, see, that virus is not a living thing. Whenever it comes in contact with a living thing, see, we are saying that wash your hands. We are all living things, right? And non-living things, like we are bringing so many things from outside, food items, right? So many things, groceries, all those, even catching mobile. Mobile is a non-living thing. It comes in contact with that, but it is harmless there. But whenever it come in contact with humans, understood, with a living cell, then it become alive, it enters inside and become alive and start dividing and multiplying and causes diseases, children. Have you understood? Now I'll show you pictures of those microbes, how they look when they are inside the microscope. Okay, when we are seeing inside the microscope, see, these are the bacterial cells. What these are all? Bacterial cells. It is in round shape, okay, chain shape, rod shape. These are all bacteria, understood, in different shapes. Now, that is about bacteria. Now, coming to, see, fungi. Fungi, I said, mushrooms and yeast, understood. This is puffball and two-thirds fungus. All these are fungus. It's look like a tree. See, once looking like a tree, right? Like a plant, not tree, plants, small plants, right? So here, these are all, what these are all? These are all nothing but fungi. Understood? Fungus start growing whenever it is favorable condition is there, then it starts growing on the dead matter. Got it, children? Now, and the next picture I'll show you. This one is protozoa. See, here I said protozoa examples I said to you. One is amoeba. See here, amoeba is this. Okay, amoeba is in different shapes. And another one is euglena. I said no, euglena. Euglena is having like this shape. See here, cell and having a tail. And paramecium. Paramecium, I said, it is like in slipper shape, isn't it? So paramecium. These are all, or these are all protozoas. Protozoa. Okay. Paramecium is an example for protozoa. Next, coming to children, virus. Our virus. See, I said to you just now, it is not a living thing. Virus is not a living thing. I said no. Whenever see the shapes of the virus. See here. Our coronavirus is like this, no? Looking like this. It is having projections, right? Projections means outcomes. Okay? And it start sticking to the, come in contact with any cell. Then it become alive. Understood? Got it, children? Now, I said about types of, first one is, I said about types of microbes. Right? Now, next topic is about these microbes are in these types only, again categorized into two main types. What are those two main types? Useful microbes. Some are useful and some are harmful. Why harmful? Harmful microbes. Microbes are again two types. Some are useful and some are harmful. Useful, they are useful to us. Understood? How they useful? These useful microbes are called good microbes. What we call? Good microbes. Understood? Harmful ones, we call it as bad microbes. What we call? Bad microbes. Understood? These are good microbes which are useful to us and which are harmful to us are considered as bad microbes. Bad microbes are also called, do you know, if they harmful to us, if any microbe causes diseases, especially disease, then we call it as pathogen. What we call? Pathogen. Understood? And generally we call it as a simple name, germs. Right? generally small kids are saying germs will be there, don't touch that one, right? We are saying, right, germs nothing but harmful. Understood? Harmful microbes, we call it as germ. Now, so when they are harmful, we call these with these names. When they are useful, we are called as just a good microbes. Now, these microbes, based on these microbes, our uses, I will tell about uses and also diseases of those microbes. Understood? Now, one by one. What are the uses of, see, tell me types. Now, tell me types. What is the first type? Bacteria, right? Bacteria. Second one, tell me children quickly. First one, bacteria. Next one, what I said? Protozoa. Third one, fungi. Fourth one, virus. Right? These are the types of microbes. Now I am saying, I am giving like uses. Understood? Uses means useful microbes are used to us. Right? Useful to us. What are those uses? I will write. Uses of bacteria. First, bacteria is used in making curd. Do you know milk? Ask your mother today. Just see once. Just take a milk. Okay. When your mother is making the curd. Okay. Just see once. If you place a drop of curd in the warm milk, then it changes into curd. By next, isn't it? Why? Because useful bacteria is there, that one changes milk into curd. Understood? And inside our body also, in our intestine, okay, those are helps in the digestion. Understood? Those are not allowing. Those are helpful for digestion and also used in making curd. Understood? Making curd. Used in making curd. Next one, this is the first use of bacteria. Now, what is this? Then harmful microbes causes what causes? I said diseases, right? What harmful microbes causes? Diseases. Useful microbes are useful to us, I said. Those are uses. Understood? Diseases now. What are those diseases? Diseases like typhoid. What is the first one? Typhoid. Have you heard this word? Yes, typhoid fever, right? Typhoid and also cholera. These are the diseases caused by bacteria. Next, coming to protozoa. What is the use of protozoa? Some protozoans are useful to us. How they are useful? They are used like a soil fertilizers. Fertilizers. What is this word? Fertilizers means? For growing the plants, we are using fertilizers, right? In the soil. Keeping in the soil so that the plant grow very well. So, some protozoans are used like a used as soil fertilizers. Have you understood, children? Now, coming to harmful. What causes, which diseases are caused by the protozoa? Protozoa causes diseases like malaria. Have you heard this word? Malaria? Malarial fever, right? Yes. This is mainly due to the protozoa. That one protozoan like plasmodium. Okay, one kind of protozoa. If it enters, okay, it passes through mosquito generally. Understood? If an infected person is there, suppose malaria person is there, then in that infected person, if the mosquito come and bites that person, then what happens? It sucks the blood, right? In the blood, the protozoans are there, plasmodium. Understood? Those enter into the mosquitoes, and again this mosquito passes to another place and bites any healthy person, then that healthy person got this malaria disease. Have you understood? So protozoa causes malaria disease. Have you understood? Next, also causes dysentery. Dysentery is nothing but both vomitings and motions. Got it? Next, coming to fungi. This is about, up to here is about protozoa. Next, coming to fungi. What are the uses of fungi? See, making bread. We are eating breads, right? Bread. And also cakes. Fluffy. very spongy, like very very smooth, right? Why? Because we are adding yeast in that. What we are adding? Yeast. Yeast makes the food into fluffy. Understood? That food becomes very very fluffy when we are adding yeast. Understood? So it is useful for us in making what? Breads and cakes. Understood? In cakes and breads we are using yeast. Next, coming to diseases. Which kind of disease we are getting with fungus? Means mainly ringworm, itching sensation. Understood? Ringworm, okay, and also athlete's foot. On the foot we are getting this disease, okay. These are the diseases caused by fungi. Next, coming to virus. Now coronavirus, tell me, you know very well what virus is causing nowadays to everyone? Cough, isn't it? Cough, cold, running nose, isn't it? Viral fever. These are all due to this virus. Got it? Now what are the uses? Uses are mainly used in the medicines. Understood? Some viruses are used in medicines also. And some causes diseases like flu, cold and cough. Understood? Viral fevers. All these are due to virus. Even chicken pox. You know chicken pox? Some lumps will be formed on the skin. These are all the uses and diseases caused by various types of microbes. Have you understood up to here, children? Now, shall I ask some questions? Tell me now, which one is helpful in making milk into curd? Yeah, bacteria, right? Bacteria, that too, one kind of bacteria, lactobacillus. Just remember that name, lactobacillus is one kind of bacteria. It changes milk into curd. Lacto means milk, understood? So, milk changes into curd with the help of lactobacillus. Have you understood, children, about all these diseases and uses? Now, coming to another topic. How this disease is spreading from one place to another place? How? Diseases are spreading, right? How these germs? Germs causes diseases. Okay, how these germs are spreading, I will tell now. Spreading of germs. What is the next topic? Spreading of germs. Germs means what I said? Harmful microbe, right? Harmful microbe, we call it as germ, I said, right? So, spreading of germs causes what? Tell me you. Just tell me now. It causes diseases, isn't it? Now, spreading of germs causes diseases. How? What are the ways? These are some ways. Some ways are there by for spreading of germs. First way. First one. How these germs are spreading? How means first one, through direct contact. Direct contact means what? Contact means attach, I said, right? Attach. Direct contact. See here, about take coronavirus only. The virus infected person, if you directly contact, understood? Means if you touch that one and if you go near to that person, then those droplets, understood, are when they cough and it comes and touches, then healthy person also gets infected. Have you understood now? That is through direct contact, spreading of germ from one person to another person. Mainly from one person to another person, then we call it as communicable disease. What is this disease name? We call it as communicable. Communication means what? Communication means exchange, right? From one person to another, communicable disease. I understood now, children? Through direct contact. Next one is through indirect contact also. Indirect means what? Indirect contact. See, indirect contact means if infected person touches any non-living thing, suppose take this marker only, okay? If infected person touches this marker, the virus, understood, not only virus, any microbe, understood, comes in contact, so that this virus or microbe come in contact with this non-living thing, understood, and this one is passed to another healthy person. Then if that healthy person touches this one, which is having, understood, even laptop, even table, everything, every place, whenever the infected person touches that one, those are come in contact with that non-living things, and those non-living things are touched by the healthy person, then that healthy person got that disease. Have you understood? So through indirect contact, like any non-living things, got it? Now next one is through spreading of disease through the air or droplets, understood, in the air. Those are with the air also transfers from one person to another person, even droplets also. Droplets means very very minute drops comes from the mouth. Those are also, okay, causes diseases. Have you understood up to here, children? Next, last one is even through vectors also. Through vectors means, I said, no, that one, what is that, malaria, I said. Malaria is caused by a mosquito. Mosquito is a vector, understood. Here, malaria person is there, understood. This malaria is infected malaria person. If a mosquito comes and bite this healthy person, and okay, if the mosquito come and bite infected person, then the microbe which is there in the malarial person is passed to the mosquito, and that mosquito, if bite healthy person, the disease is caused to, the malarial disease is passed to healthy person. So mosquito is a carrier here. What it is? Carrier. Understood? Carrier also called vector. I understood what are the ways through from one person to another person, how the microbe is transferred. I understood. So these are main, all these ways, through all these ways except this one, the virus, our coronavirus is spreading from one person to another person. Last topic is how to avoid. Understood? How to avoid spreading of diseases. I'll show some pics to you, children. See, this is spreading. How to avoid spreading of disease? These are the ways of spreading. Now, how to avoid? Ways to avoid spreading. What are the ways we need to follow to avoid spreading? Those we call it as generally specific name, precautions, right? What precautions we need to take to avoid disease, okay? To avoid disease, those are called precautions. First one, see, I'll show you. First, avoid touching your eyes, mouth, nose. Understood? Infected, if you touch any infected person, and if you touch with the same hand, you're rubbing your eyes and nose and mouth, those germs, okay, enter into your body, and you also get it infected. So first one is avoid touching infected persons. Understood? Infectious persons. Have you understood, children, up to here? Next one is, suppose if you touch also, okay, if you touch also, just immediately, see here, wash your hands thoroughly with soap. Understood? Next one is, immediately wash. If you touch also, wash your hands Have you understood? Wash your hands immediately. For about 20 seconds said, right? So wash your hands. That is one way of not spreading disease, coronavirus especially. Next, coming to third one. Cover your mouth and nose with the mask. They are saying, right? See, if you are following all these precautions, then you won't get disease, right? First, so use mask to cover your mouth. While you are coughing and sneezing also, don't cough like this. Use just your elbow and cough and sneeze. Understood, children? So that you can avoid direct contact with spreading of those microbes to healthy person. If you do like this, so here only the germs will be. Understood? Got it? Microbes won't pass. Next one is use mask and immediately throw into dustbin. Don't use that one again and again. Understood? Using after throw, fold it and throw. Otherwise it may spread. Got it? Use mask and throw it in to dustbin. Have you understood? Next four. Last one is after using all these, even if you have any symptoms, then go and seek a medical advice. Means ask your family doctor help. Got it? So at last what I'm saying is stay safe and stay healthy, children. Use only, ask your mother, see, this is the main one. Eat fresh food. Fresh food means fruits and vegetables, freshly cooked food. Understood? So only eat hygienic food, very very fresh one. Eat and avoid disease. Understood? Avoid spreading of disease. Have you understood, children? Yeah. Now I'm going to give at the last a small project for you all. Do this one at home and take a pic of that and paste in the scrapbook, children. First project. This is the last part of this topic. What is the project I am giving to you? Just take a bread slice. Take a bread slice and pour a few drops on it. Water drops. Drops means water drops on it. And keep it aside for 2 to 3 days. Understood? Leave it aside. After 2 or 3 days, then you will find some black spots on it. Those are nothing but moles. What are those moles? You will find moles on the bread. This is bread slice. Understood? This is bread slice. When you pour some few drops on it and keep it aside for 2 to 3 days, then you will find moles. Moles are nothing but microbes. Which type of microbes? Those are fungi, right? I said fungi. Do this project, understood, at home and take a pic means take a photo and paste that photo in your scrapbook. Understood? So don't spread the disease of that coronavirus. Stay healthy and stay safe. Thank you, children.